Madmen star Christina Hendricks was guest of honour at a swish party this week. The proud spectacle wearer is encouraging Australians to make a spectacle of themselves to be named Specsavers Spectacle Wearer of the Year.
You've come all the way to Australia to help launch the Spectacle Wearer of the Year. What's that all about?
Well, this is the third year that Specsavers has conducted this contest, really. And it's about people who wear spectacles or wear them as a fashion accessory to be confident and be an individual and to be beautiful. And they can submit a picture of them in their spectacles to the Specsavers Australia Facebook page. And then in a couple months, we'll have a panel of people who choose a winner. And the winner gets to get a year contract with Scoop Management and also fly out to Los Angeles, and we're going to do a photo shoot. And I'll get to go there and help style it and help direct, which will be fun for me. So it's good. And we're going to have a bunch of finalists as well, and they're all going to get to have great prizes as well.
Dorothy Parker once said, men seldom make passes at girls who wear glasses. Is that true?
Well, not in my case. My husband actually encourages me to wear them. He thinks it's sexy, so.
Absolutely, and I have to agree. They look absolutely fabulous, but we didn't
Thank
know you.
You
wore glasses.
I do. I've worn them since high school. I usually keep four or five pairs around, actually. It's like mix up my look.
So when Joan, your character on Mad Men, puts the glasses on, was that your idea or was it Matthew's?
That was actually Matt Weiner's idea to do the glasses, and I like that it shows just another side of Joan at home, comfortable.
The storyline that your character Joan had this season was so powerful, and it resonated so much with what decisions a woman had to make for her family, for her career. Was it an amazing storyline for you?
Absolutely. It was a storyline that Matt Weiner had presented to me actually maybe one or two seasons ago. Uh-huh. And he knew he had wanted to use it because he had heard so many real life stories of this sort of scenario happening at work. And he said, you know, I can't not use this. It says so much about the environment and what women have to decide for themselves and what they would do to protect their family and protect themselves. And so I knew it was going to be controversial, and then that's exciting as an actress to be able to have material like that. And I thought he handled it so beautifully too. It really was one of those things that raised questions and got conversations going, and I was sort of proud to be a part of it.
Do you see parallels with what the women in the office were going through in the 60s and now? Do you think things have changed that much?
I think things have certainly changed. I don't think they've changed enough. I think that, you know, women are constantly having struggles for empowerment and dealing with, so many things, criticism and power and all of those things. But my goodness, I'd so much rather be living now and have the opportunities that we have now than in the 1960s.
At last year's Emmys, you wore a dress by an Australian designer, Joanna Johnson. Are you going to catch up with her while you're here?
I was hoping. I'm waiting to hear back. I'm hoping that her schedule works out so we can at least have a coffee. We've sent each other emails, and she's been so lovely, and she sent me flowers when I was nominated, and she's been really, really sweet. So I hope I get to meet her in person.
I thought you were robbed, by the way. In all seriousness, Dame Maggie Smith,
She's
bad.
Maggie Smith. She's amazing.
She's got so many awards. She's done heaps of stuff. And she is great in Downton Abbey. However, I thought also Jared Harris's Lame was robbed. Well, you were all robbed. How did you come away from that with no wins from all those nominations?
Well, we sort of saw the silver lining and said, look, we still made history. No one's ever lost that many awards in one night. We're so proud to make that show that... I mean, I know it sounds a little bit cheesy, but we feel like we win every day when we go to work. And it's really great to be acknowledged and to win and to go and celebrate and get dressed up real pretty and do all of that. But we go back to work in 3 weeks, and I feel like the luckiest girl in the world. So,
the beautiful clothes that your character Joan wears on Mad Men, are you excited every time you see the new wardrobe? They're always so beautifully accessorized.
Yes, Janie Bryant is our costume designer, and... I'm glad you even said the accessories because she does not miss a beat. If it's Thanksgiving, I have a little acorn or a turkey or something. And if it's Christmas, there's little bells on my ears. So sometimes not everyone notices it, but we get a kick out of it. And we like that Joan was very festive with her accessories.
And have you seen the influence of the fashion from Mad Men out in the real world?
I think the whole show has influenced fashion, which is kind of amazing to watch. There's been sort of a time where we were walking into stores to go shopping, and I'm like, I can't buy that dress. It looks like a Joan costume. I'm going to look like I'm crazy if I walk around like that. But I actually love how that looks anyways, and I like that each woman on the show has a sort of different silhouette and a different style, and you know, I'm definitely the pencil skirt, and January is definitely the full, you know, feminine skirt, and Peggy's got her little ties and things and more suits. So I like that different types are represented as well.
I believe you're making a movie with Ryan Gosling.
Well, Ryan called me a couple months ago and said that he'd been working on the script and had thought of me for the lead character, and would I be interested in reading it? And of course I was giddy with excitement, and it's his directorial debut, which is so cool. So I was incredibly flattered, and he sent over this really great, amazing script, and he's already got storyboards and art and music, and I think he's going to be a great director. So as soon as I finish this season, we're going to start on that.
And does your character spend some time or end up in a fetish club? Did I read?
She ends up finding herself in a fetish club, yes.
So working in a movie in a fetish club with Ryan Gosling, to me that's 50 Shades of okay.
That's just like a good dream, right?
Yeah. That works fine.
Yeah.
Well, I hope you enjoy your stay, as short as it is, and come back again soon.
Well, I'm going to try to enjoy every last minute before I get on that plane.